Dogs VIP. Let's kick it. Collaborate and listen. I sit back with my brand new invention. Something grabs a hold of me tightly. Flow like a harpoon daily and nightly.
Will it ever stop?
Yo, I don't know. Turn off the lights and I'll glow. To the extreme, I rock a mic like a vandal. Light up a stage and wax a chump like a candle.
Dance.
Crush a speaker that booms. I'm killing your brain like a poisonous mushroom.
Deadly.
When I play a dope melody, anything less than the best is a felony. Love it or leave it. You better gain weight. You better hit bulls out of kid don't play. If there was a problem, yo, I'll solve it. Check out the hook while my DJ revolves it.
Good morning, Eagle Nation. It's another Ridiculous Friday with Vanilla Ice. It's the 23rd of September, and it's the 37th day of school. That's your song. You asked for it. You got it. Wherever you may be, please stop, please stand. Let us rise together for this morning's Pledge of Allegiance. But first, now let us rise for this morning's Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may be seated, because Friday is the day when we rest our bodies, and when you get to 3:30, you can rest your mind, but don't do it prematurely. Today, we have a couple of absences. Ms. Juliana is out in kindergarten. Ms. Brown is also out in kindergarten. And Ms. Alexis Cordova also will be out today. Mr. Gary will be in kindergarten with the support of Mr. Paul Mosier and the additional support, at least temporarily, with Mr. Victor Cruz, only at a couple strategic times. So seventh graders, you will still see Mr. Cruz later today. I want to thank all of you for jumping in to help out where possible and where necessary to make sure that all of you students get what you need. Let's get to the end of today successfully and together. Also, to keep you informed, you may have seen Ms. Newbill. She is the art candidate that I've been interviewing this week and that visited in some of your classrooms. Some of you from G Road already know who she is, but I will be recommending her for hire. And if all goes well and she accepts, then we will have finally our art teacher. Likely that will begin after October break, again, assuming everything goes well, but stay tuned. I'm hopeful. She sounds very excited about it, and we're excited to have her, so let's hope that that pans out, but I will keep all of you abreast. Today, though, there will be no art class, and so teachers, I am asking you to cover your art classes for today and to see Fabiola for a split pay subform. I do appreciate your flexibility. It is a Friday. Let's get there. If you need out for a minute, all you got to do is call the front office. I will come and make sure you get a break. Let's do it. Today, we continue our celebration of Hispanic Heritage Month, and I'm going to be reading Chato's Kitchen today in the kindergarten classroom. They invited me to read at 8:45, and I wanted to share a new one with you today, briefly anyway, if you'd like to borrow this one. This is called Isabel and her Colores Go to School. It is by Alexandra Alessandri and illustrated by Courtney Dawson. She is a Colombian-American poet and writer, excuse me, who wrote this particular children's book. And what's unique about this one, unlike any of the other books that I've read this week, this one is presented both in English and in Spanish. First page. The night before the first day of school, Isabel sat cross-legged on her bed, coloreando with her favorite crayons. Rojo, verde, azul, rosado, morado, violeta. La noche antes de su primer día de escuela, Isabel se sentó en su cama con las piernas cruzadas, coloreando con sus crayones favoritos, rojo, verde, azul, rosado, morado, violeta. Estaba lista para las clases, solo que... She was ready for class, except... Except what? Turn the page to find out. Perhaps you have been new to a school, a club, a church, a team, or even a neighborhood. And you remember that feeling of what it is to be new and to be unknown to others, how frightening it can be. And if you've ever been the person on the other side of that same coin, you also might remember what it feels like to have tremendous power to be able to make that new person feel welcome, included, invited, and the important role that language can play in that process. If you're interested, I invite you teachers to borrow this book, Isabel and Her Colores, to share with your students. Or if you'd like to invite me to read, I'd be more than happy to do so at any level, kindergarten through eighth grade. Just say the word and I'll be there. If you'd like to just check it out because you'd like the honors of doing that, please just let me know and we'll make sure that you can check this out from me. All right, let's get to some words of wisdom so you can get to the business of teaching and learning. Our football team presently is 2-1, still has a winning record, and our volleyball team won again last night. So volleyball team is on a roll. Both teams are winners, and more importantly than being winners constantly and consistently, you represent Emerson and you make us proud. Just know that we're with you in spirit if we're not there with you in person, and perhaps we can coordinate a time when we transcend upon the field and maybe coordinate a night where we all come to support you at volleyball and flag football. Let's try and do that. All right, now some words of wisdom so you can get to the business of teaching and learning. And how appropriate, today is about making a difference. And it is also from Dolores Huerta. Dolores Huerta spent a great deal of her life serving others by working to help American farm workers. Listen to what she has to say to us today. We must use our lives to make the world a better place, not just to get things. That is what we are put here on earth for. What do you think? Do you think we are here on earth so we can see who gets to wear the most expensive clothes? Are we here to do good in the world? Do you think too many people are more worried about buying things than about doing things to help others? Think of Dolores Huerta and start making the world a better place. Do at least one special something to help someone else today. With something to think about. This is Mr. Lodato. Mask up. Hats and hoods off indoors. Stay in your zones. Put away your phones and make it a great day or not. The choice is yours.